easy as cat fuck. Jesus Christ. Well, here I am, back in the wasteland again, wandering around, overclocking my GPU to crazy high levels, seeing if Fallout will be stable. Probably won't, though.
Bait Shop's got everything you need.
Didn't I put in a fucking mod to keep people from talking to me about mundane shit? Did that guy just say the Vape Shop has everything I need? Where am I going? What are we doing? I haven't been here in a while. I'm brain dead. Speak with Maxwell. Okay. It says he's 32 meters away. Oops, that's a wall. That's a gate. With my poor vision, it makes you wonder how I'm able to kill so easily.
Dock and back.
God, I should, like, do fucking voice work for cartoons. With as savage as my burps are, you know? Maybe it's this guy I have to speak to.
You're from the Commonwealth, right?
Dude, your hair! It must be a modding compatibility with Far Harbor. Or that guy just has really bad hair. Fallout looks amazing after you have around 200 mods on it. Too bad this renders like shit, though. Whoop, that's poisonous gas. As I was saying, too bad this game renders like shit, though, on YouTube. Well, I mean, like, you know, the video rendering. Dog meat found something? Ah, shit, Jesus Christ! What the fuck, man? I was so not ready. Shoot him again. Shoot him again. You fucking fuck. Fuck, fuck, fuck. Fuck you, you fucking dead piece of shit. Jesus Christ, you can't even look at the scenery without something trying to claw your fucking eye. What the fuck? I'm so disturbed I can't even aim. Oh wait, I'm using a controller. And that just explains why I can't aim. People are fucking ghouls out here. What's with all this fog? It's not toxic from the looks of things. It's just fog. That's a motel, which doesn't make much sense. This is a motel, considering that big thing over there is a motel. Like, who would put up this tiny-ass motel versus that? Unless the bigger motel came later, like Walmart did in my town, and it totally fucked over the small mom-and-pop-owned bookstore. And it had a lot of, like, charm. I used to go there and hang out before hipsters took over. Goddamn hipsters. You can't have nothing cool because of them. Like, I have vinyl records, but I can't play them because then everybody thinks I'm a fucking hipster. What the hell did I just kick? Oh, a globe. It's in great shape. Alright. Back to doing what I gotta do. Hey, it's a stone walkway. Oh, it's wood. Sorry. I should probably pay attention. Because you just don't know what the fuck could pop out here and butt-fuck you. Without total remorse. Everything is like a brazier scene. It's all butt sex. And you're the bottom. Is that it? Is that where I'm supposed to go? Alright, time to get sneaky, sneaky. Because just running into it is... Hold on, hold on. Nick, will you sit down? That's hard to see. Let's go in first person. Oh. Okay, fuck that.
Come on now.
Okay, here we go. Good old-fashioned Ada, please. Ada. Ada. Why are you so loud? You've ruined it, you stupid robot. Oh, wow. The irony. He is going to splatter my brains, and I blew his out. Wait, trouble, trouble. God damn, they got great aim. Right in his kneecaps. Or not, you know. Fuck it. I used to be an adventurer like you, and then I took a 12-gauge slug to the knee. No, don't drink the water! Don't drink the water! God, I had a Dave Matthews Band moment. Oh, Jesus Christ. Do I have enough bullets for this? Yeah, I got 5 bullets left. Better make them count. And shotgun. Oh, that's the EBKR. What's this thing? It's empty, that's for fucking sure. What is he wearing? Is that a mask? Oh, it's like a blood effect that didn't take on his face. I'm out of bullets. Fuck. Jump. Jump. Don't jump. Do something. Pick a gun. Oh, God. My least favorite gun. Now I got you, fucktard. Or I don't. I don't have you at all. I cannot believe this. She missed twice and he's right in front of you. I could have shot him. Okay, no, I couldn't have. I missed. Oh, fuck you. Just have that. Go suck a dick. You could burn too, motherfucker. Dude. Shit. This is going wrong. Really? Ah, Jesus Christ! I'm going to die if you don't pick a gun that isn't garbage. What, am I out of bullets again? I will be beaten to death. What? Do I have no melee skill? Oh, Jesus. Bite him, dog meat, bite him. Yeah, that's empty too. All right, fuck it. Fuck you, go into this. Embarrassing. Here we go, the room clearer. Yeah, motherfucker, how you like that? Jeez. Made a total ass of me. So I think my neighbor's gay. I like fell off the roof of my garage while trying to clean it. And he tried to hop over a fence and said he'd give me mouth-to-mouth resuscitation. And I told him, I said, Teddy, I'm fine. What are you doing? I'm not unconscious. And he's like, don't worry about it, Chaz. I'm just here to help. And I was starting to scream like a white girl. Hey, there's a door. Excitement in my voice. There's a door. Hey, booze. Let's take a beer. And Jesus Christ. Could someone explain this to me? Okay. This is like, how did this happen? The guy is like buried in garbage? But how? Why? What? Who would take this much time to bury a man in trash? I don't even... This makes no sense to me. This actually reminds me of a story of my childhood. Now we go to memory lane with Gundam. Hold on. I remember once, like, there's like this house near my grandmother's house. It looked old and abandoned, and it was just like some guy who lived there. I don't know. Maybe he like died. He's like super fat and whatnot, right? So one day a construction crew comes to just run his house over, you know, like crush it and shit and get rid of it, knock it down, bulldoze it, whatever the hell you call it. So this dude's house gets knocked down, right? And I'm outside walking my chihuahua. Yeah, a real badass dog. You know, I lived in a black neighborhood. I didn't belong there. And if he could make me stick out anymore, they got me a chihuahua. You know, the black guys had Rottweilers. I had a dog that was the size of their dog shit. So anyway, this place gets knocked down, right? And I swear to God, when I was walking my chihuahua, I like a piece of paper fell on my face. It like just flew in my face and, you know, hit me right in the face. Like, you know how in movies a paper flies in a hero's face, he takes it off, and he's like, there's a job opening that I can fit in. All right. No, the paper hit me in the face. I pulled it off and it was fucking pornography. And I'm like, what the fuck? Now, this is like back in the day before the internet kicked ass. So if you really wanted to see tits, you had to like download a photo for like 2 fucking hours. Well, pornography just flying in your face was like instant transmission porn, like today. You know, kids today don't appreciate pornography because it's right there, easy to get. In my day, it was like Lord of the Rings. You had to travel fucking 7 hours on foot to meet a guy whose best friend had a lawyer that happened to sell pornography if you traded him certain rare PlayStation games. You know, it was a bartering system. It was like Final Fantasy. All right, I'm gonna stop now. But anyway, back to the main story. So I look down because like all of a sudden my feet, it's like this crunchy stuff. And I go, oh my fucking God. And the ground was covered in pornography, just like this. Magazines upon magazines of dirty magazines. Did I say magazines enough? tons of filthy pornography. I was like, oh my fucking God, I've hit Shangri-La of porn. And you know, like, the fucking construction workers got the best porn first, and the rest are just left on the ground like, eh, fuck it. I bet the dude's house, like, when they bulldozed it, it just, like, shot porn into the air like snowflakes in a fucking neighborhood full of kids. And you're just like, yes, it's raining porn. Ah, a Christmas miracle. Run down the street and get me the biggest Christmas goose you can, Bob Cratchit.
Or something.
Because I found pornography. Wait, you hear that? Oh, shit. Oh, damn. Good shot, Ada. I'm sitting here trying to tell a fantastic story of my childhood and a super mutant tries to commit suicide. Story of my life. So, yeah, that was, like, my big porn thing. And here's the sad part. Like, I went to go get a cousin of mine, and we grabbed as much porn as we could get, and then I got, like, a steamer trunk or something, right? A small one. And we took the best porn we could and stuffed it in there, and then we buried it like treasure. That's my point. You kids today don't appreciate porn. You just put it on your hard drive. It's there whenever you want it. When I was a kid, you had to not only find it, you had to hide it from raiders who would steal your pornography. All right, so my game crashed while I was telling my fabulous story. Long story short, one day I went outside to go see my pornography, like, ooh, porn day, it's a lovely day for porn. And it wasn't even good porn. It was like porn from the 80s and the 70s and the 90s. You know, because that's back when porn magazines were big. And there'd be chicks with crazy, crazy huge pubic hair. God, you had to be a real man to, you know, have some lady lunch, if you will, and it was covered in that atrocious hair. It looked like a fucking tribble. If you don't know what a tribble is, look up tribble, Star Trek, you'll find out what a tribble is. So one day I get up to go.
Your funeral.
Oh, man. So one day I get up to go look at my porn, and the most horrible thing happened. The construction crew paved over where I buried my porn. So my porn box, my porn treasures, were under like 3 feet of concrete. And I remember just sitting there trying to devise ways to dig under the concrete like a fucking porn squirrel or something to try and get it back. It's like, maybe if I make a tunnel here, I can get my pornography. Oh, God. Misspent youth. I spent so many days going back and trying to devise plots. But when you're a kid, you're, like, limited to whatever you can find in your parents' garage. And so I was trying to dig out the porn with a fucking really big spoon and, like, a gardening hoe thingy. Like, the kind you get on your knees and you garden with. And I don't know. Like, it's in all those Hollywood movies about the 30s. Like, it's like this scooper for picking up dirt and you plant shit. It didn't go well. I had to let it go. It was a sad day for porn. You know, I don't know about you, but I can tell you this about me. I quote drag queens a lot.
Let's take them out.
Oh. Little Latin boy in drag, why are you crying?
Why are you crying?
Don't come for me. And stick to this, and there we go. Lockpicking is actually more complicated than this. I learned how to lockpick recently.
Nice.
I just never carry bobby pins with me, so it's like a skill I learned how to do, and then I never carry bobby pins with me. So I should probably work on that. Like, why would I learn lockpicking and not carry any of the tools with me? It's like stupid. Like, I could get trapped somewhere. And it's like, I can get us out of here if I had a bobby pin. And then the chick would be like, oh my God, do you have one, Charles? And I'd be like, no, I don't. Do I hear anything? And it's just her. Sounds like gunfire.
Can you see them, then?
Obviously not. You're the one with the advanced sensors and shit. I'm fucking human. kind of like how Zill says there's certain places in Asia you can't go because they eat cats. You just never know. And then he asked me if I'd eat a cat. And I'm like, if I was like living in Asia or something and eating cats is normal, I'm pretty sure I'd eat a cat. Like if the cat was dead first, I wouldn't want to kill the cat then eat it. Like if I was starving and the cat dropped dead. Ugh. I also practiced on making my burps sound like frog sounds, just in case I ever got stuck in the rainforest and I needed to fool a crocodile into not eating me. You're probably like, wow, Chaz, you have a contingency plan for everything. You must be Batman. Once, twice, three times, lady. I don't even know what the fuck that did. Oh, once again, going in the wrong direction. Get back. Stop moving, robot. Get ready. Go. Ah! Fuck you, fucker. It doesn't seem smart enough to move. So this kind of isn't the epic battle I thought it was going to be. Like, really. I could dance around. See this? In fact, it's such a lame battle. I'm going to pull up a chair. Camp chair. Let's drop it. There we go. Here we go. Sit down. You cannot use this while in combat. Really? Look at this. Have a drink. This is going to be great. Boom. Modders kick ass. Oh my god.
Oh, Grandpa George. Torn apart by a fog crawler. The island hasn't got a shred of decency.
Yeah, the island sucks a lot of dick. You won't get an argument out of me there. Well, this big shithole is mine now. What I've always wanted. A horrible looking farm. To call my own. Apparently two assholes live here already. Okay. Really? Oh shit, what is that? Ooh. Holy shit! Jesus Christ! What the it's fucking vicious! Fuck it. Ah! Jesus! Someone get it off of me! I can't swim! There's a whole shit ton of them! Don't even aim, just shoot! Oh, I'm so dead! I'm so dead! Well, that was a clusterfuck. If I ever saw one. It's kind of fucked when you're proud of a video game, dog. Ah! Ah! Jesus Christ! Oh my god. Nick, you fucking asshole. You're supposed to be watching my back. Jesus fucking Christ, man. Jesus. I'm sorry. Like, I'm being all quiet because I'm really actually trying to check where the fuck I'm going. Did you hear that? Did you hear it? Jesus, just shoot it. Just shoot it, for God's sakes. Kill it. Kill it. Kill it. Kill it. When I give you an order to shoot something, God damn it, don't think. Just shoot. Oh, God. Look at the size of its fucking mouth. This thing swallows people whole.
Find anything useful?
It's a fucking salamander on cocaine mixed with fucking crazy ass levels of goddamn vitamin C. Fucker.